press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
I realize an identity of a woman is the one that takes somehow precedence over everything else, because whether you're being praised or you're being criticized or you're being doubted or you're being questioned, you're just never allowed to forget that, you know, you're a woman and you just want to be treated as a person. As a child, I never grew up with mainstream cinema because my parents didn't watch it. So it was just that big world of Bollywood I was just not exposed to. Acting was totally not on the cards, and fire led to sort of more projects coming my way. So I just did it because it spoke to me and I just felt like I wanted to be part of it. And I enjoyed the experience. It was a very intimate set, mainly with Shivanaji and Deepa and I. So, you know, it was just very sort of, it was a very intimate experience. And I didn't know that it would open up this huge debate. Of course, I knew there would be some conversation around it, but I didn't know, for instance, it would be attacked in the way it got attacked. I didn't know that it would invoke such a strong reaction of all kinds, that people would also take to the streets and, you know, sort of speak up for it. It also gave a space to talk about freedom of expression, whether people liked it or didn't like it. So many of the things that we are grappling with today, in some ways I felt that, you know, I'd seen the seed of it then. I mean, today, thankfully, you know, homosexuality has been decriminalized and it's taken so long, but I want to believe that fire did sow some seed and, you know, at least gave us a vocabulary to talk about it, and it became a conversation in the public space. When I used to do sort of more rural characters or lower class, lower caste characters, then my skin color was fine. But when I would do a character that was sort of middle class, educated, you know, a little more affluent, someone like you and me, they would tell me, I know you don't like to put makeup, but can you make your skin lighter? Because this is an educated person. I was like, what? Then it's a wrong casting. You shouldn't have taken me if that's your criteria. I said, but don't you see that you're talking to somebody who's educated, who is from that class of people, as you say, and why? He said, no, but people don't accept it, you know? So this is the kind of vicious circle we are in, that makers want to continue that stereotype because they think people don't accept it. People feel this is what we are given, so how do we change our mindset? And it's just sort of endless. In many ways, I think it impacted me, and I realized that we live in a fairly insensitive society, in a hypocritical society where we do have double standards, where there's a lot that we don't really talk about. Manto said that if you can't bear my stories, it's because we live in unbearable times. And that kind of reflects that, you know, that you want to work that is going to show the good and the bad of the world. You know, a lot of the times I'm accused of doing films where we show the ugly side of reality. Like, why do we have to show that? Does that put India, does it show India in a bad light? In fact, if you love your country, you love your people, you love everything there is around you, you are going to also see the good and the bad. Because till you don't see the bad, if you don't acknowledge it, how are you going to ever improve it? As a female director, for the longest time, I didn't like this label at all. Because I used to think that, you know, when you're directing, you're not thinking like a woman. That's one of your many identities. If my cinematographer and I are saying something, often many people in the team would listen to him or, you know, would sort of say, oh, he told us this. Yet sometimes the team feels that, oh, you know, she's still a woman. I mean, you very subtly feel it. Of course, half the time, many people are calling you sir and then they go, oh, ma'am, you know, things like that. But they're so used to men helming a project. You know, when you're directing, you're not thinking like a woman. That's one of your many identities. I'm sure it impacts you. But now I'm much more at peace with it, because I often say that there should be more women who should be making films, because we need more diverse stories. Broadly, I would say I'm someone who is restless, who is a seeker, who is troubled by everything that's happening around us, frustrated and helpless sometimes, but also optimistic. And I do believe that, you know, we are a drop in the ocean, but we've got to do our drop well.